the prep time has up. Welcome to Waseda University to join in the Japan BP Judge Test 2014. Today, Waseda this house believes that the government of developing countries should not allow foreign large retailers, example Walmart, Costco, etc., etc., to advance into their market. The first one call upon the Prime Minister to deliver your constant speech within 7 minutes. Yeah, yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and hello, ladies and gentlemen in this house. After allowing advancement from foreign countries or developed countries, the markets in the developing country are harmed by the advancement by the developed country, foreign countries retailers. And in order to support domestic industry, government have to ban foreign retailers to advance into the market. So we are happy to propose this motion. So today I would like to talk about two things. First of all, why government has legitimacy to intervene, and secondly, I'll talk about after advancement, the domestic industry will get harmed, and if we ban the advancement, we can regulate to some extent to intervene by the foreign retailers and protect domestic industry. So, first of all, government have the legitimacy to ban allowing foreign retailers to advance, because government has duty to support domestic industry and support markets and shopping arcades in the developing countries. Because people in the developing countries market or shopping arcades, there are a lot of people working there. For example, before allowing advancement, there is vegetable store and medicine store, pharmacy or other services. There is a lot of workers in there. However, after allowing advancement, all services and all shops are included in the large retailers from foreign country, and the people will lose job after allowing advancement. So government have to protect employees in the developing countries, so government has legitimacy to protect them. So I will move on to second argument. What will happen after allowing advancement by foreign retailers, and if banning advancement from the developed country, we can protect the developing countries industry? Yes.
Do you also oppose allowing other types of multinational corporation to come into the market, like oil major or water companies or other types of businesses and enterprise on your side of the house?
We believe that allowing the intervention from foreign large retailers lead to allowing the other industry to come, because in the retailer shops, there is there are many products from the country, so it allows the other industry to come. So I will move back to my argument. After allowing advancement by foreign retailers, foreign retailers will capture the market in the developing country, and also domestic industry in the developing country cannot grow up. For example, products, it is difficult to sell the products from the developing countries, because the products from from foreign countries, mainly developed countries, are convenient because they don't have to go a lot of shops in the market, and they can in one place they can buy the everything they need in the daily life. And also, thanks to the mass production, the price of the products from the developed country are reasonable, and the people in the developing country have access to buy the products from the developed country. And also, the foreign industry have the high quality to produce the product. So, developing countries people in developing country are attracted to buy the products from the developed countries, and they never go to the their domestic markets and the domestic shopping arcades. Yes.
But so long is cheaper food, higher quality food, and so forth for the happiness of developing countries people.
We can see that the access to more and more access to buy the products from developed country contributes to the happiness of developing country. But protecting the employees are prioritized in this case. So I'll move back to my argument. After advancement, the people engaging in the domestic industry will lose job, like Japan's shadow shopping arcades. They cannot get enough customer to continue to run the shops. So they have to close the shops, and they have to they have no market to sell their products. So if government ban the advancement from the foreign countries, we can keep the good balance of the access to foreign countries' products. And because taking this motion can enable us to regulate the advancement from the foreign countries' products to come to the developing country, because the access to buy the products from developing country are to some extent limited, but people can continuously buy what they really want. It is happy for the developing country's industry. So for these reasons, we apply to support this motion. Thank you.
Thank you, Prime Minister. Next one, Carl Pons, the leader of opposition, to deliver your point of speech in 7 minutes. Here.
We strongly believe that this motion works to advertise the large foreigners retailers works really well in the developing countries. And before moving on to my argument, I want to explain what model do we stand for. And number one, we oppose complete monopoly, and we will enforce monopoly laws to prevent price gouging. And number two, for jobless people, we will give them an employment benefit and welfare. And next, I want to explain about, I want to show what stance we stand for. And our stance is that we are happy to allow any multinational enterprise and business to come to developing nations, not limited to retailers, because that maximizes the accessibility to more diverse products with lower price. So, all rebutters are included in my speech. So let me move on to my argument. Today I have three points to talk about. And first, after taking this proposal, the price of the if we advertise the local, the foreign large retailers, we can the price of the products will go down in the developing countries. And second, consumers will access larger quantities of the products. And the last point is foreign large retailers create massive employment and jobs and give them like know-how and technologies. So let me explain about the first argument. The price of the product will go down. So if we think about the uniqueness of the foreign larger retailers, they can sell much cheaper products comparing to the domestic retailers in developing countries, because the those foreign retailers can product in more larger scales, after that, a lot of cheaper products come into the market in the developing countries. After that, other domestic companies can also have to make the price down, because the domestic retailers also have to be competitive to those foreign retailers, so they have to make the price down. So, and why it's good, because Mr. Speaker, in developing countries, there are a lot of poor people who cannot buy the stuff that they definitely need in their normal life. For example, like water or vegetables or like toilet papers and so on. And after that, poor people also will be able to buy these products at cheap cost. Because, as I said, the foreign retailers can sell more cheaper. So so why it's good after that? So especially for poor people, if they can buy the stuffs at cheap cost, they can save money for they can save money for other things like to educate children or and so on. Yeah.
It seems you're contradicting yourself, right? If you disallow foreign companies to manipulate price as they wish, how can you guarantee they come into the developing country to sell cheaper price, to sell products in cheaper price?
I will explain it later. So, it will increase the quality of life in the developing countries of like the poor people, so they can get like water, vegetables to live more happier and so on. So let me move on to next argument. So consumers will access larger quantity of the products. So under the status quo, there are some or many products that developing country that cannot product in their country because geographically or climate, because of the climate, there are some steps that the developing country itself cannot product. For example, like rice or the supply of the water. No, thank you. They need those products like rice or like vegetables. So to get those products more accessibly, we think that to advance those foreign large retailers is a good way. No, thank you. Because the foreign large retailers have more diversity of the products that they can sell, and as I said before, they can sell more cheaper. So this is really good for the people in the developing country. And moving on to my the last argument about foreigners, retailers create massive employment and jobs and give them,
The argument you talked about, for example, vegetable not being able to get in hand. Don't you think that argument is not about retailer, but it's about import, which we are happy to allow it on our side of the house too.
Are you talking about importing?
Yes.
Comparing to the import, they have to. They cannot sell if they import stuff. They cannot sell more, cheaper because they have to put tariff on the product. So we think that our, it's better. So moving on to the last argument, foreign large retailers create massive employment jobs and give them know-how and technology. So because the large foreign retailers, they need a lot of workers in the developing countries, and they will, the job opportunity will be more, increased because the foreign large retailers will need workers, and also they have more liberal thinking, so they will, hire more women as well. For example, like Walmart also hired a lot of women in the developing countries, and why it's good is to because if they can get knowledge or technology, they can the domestic it will more benefit for the domestic country. So we will be opposed to this motion. Thank you.
Thank you, leader opposition. Let's look upon the deputy prime minister to deliver his speech within 7 minutes. Hear, hear.
Mr. and Madam Chair, Mr. and Madam Speakers, we believe that the government have the right to protect their own industry, to protect their own employees or workers. Furthermore, we believe that we can protect their own industry by taking this motion. In addition to it, I want to talk about why, in their paradigm, consumers also have to suffer from the foreign products. And secondly, I want to talk about why this India paradigm, the principle of free market, also can be harmed. This is my argument in this debate. Before moving on to my argument, I want to give them a few rebuttals. Firstly, they said that they can protect the poor because in their paradigm, poor can access more food and more clothes because the domestic industry have more incentive to reduce the price, but it's not true. The result is that in their paradigm, the number of the poor will just increase because first of all, the workers for domestic industry will lose jobs in their paradigm. No, thank you. Because simply because they have no ability to decrease prices. First of all, they have no technique to massive production. They have they have little technique, and they have little equipment to produce product efficiently. And even in the current situation, they have the strong incentive to sell the product. That's why they have already done the effort to sell a price with cheaper a product with cheaper price. That's why in their paradigm, because of the existence of the foreign products, they cannot compete because they cannot increase the price. That's why they will lose job. That's why the number of the poor will increase in their paradigm. Then, they said that the foreign products, a foreign retailer is beneficial in terms of recruitment and new technology. But both are not true. First of all, as for the recruitment, the foreign retailers have no incentive to employ indigenous people, simply because they can produce the product with fewer people because they have the technique to produce the product with the technique and with the machine and with the great equipment. That's why they have no necessity to recruit native people. Thirdly, they said that the new foreign company will introduce a new technology to the developing country, but it's also not true because the foreign company have no incentive to tell the great technique to the developing country. First of all, if the native people work for the foreign company, then they will be lower employees because they have no, they are not educated in generally speaking, and they have no special technique to work for the company at higher status. That's why the employee who work for the company will not get any new technique from the company.
Point.
That's, go ahead.
Foreign large retailers have massive incentive to hire local people because local people have superiority, like, for example, knowing local their own languages, like, for example, knowing the local transportation system, like, for example, knowing the local demand the best. Don't you think so?
What I want to say is that the company is the company has the incentive to recruit few people because, as you said, they need to recruit few people to success in the country, but they have no necessity to recruit a lot of people, and a lot of people who work for in the current situation will lose job because they cannot be recruited. That's my answer to the POI. I want to move on to my first argument. So we believe that this motion, in their paradigm, consumers have to be harmed because of the foreign products, because the foreign company will be dominate in the local market. For example, if the people go to the store or shop, then all the store and shop are full of foreign products and foreign clothes and foreign food and foreign electricity products. No, thank you. This means that the local market strongly relies on the foreign products. What happened? Clearly, the local market will be subject to foreign companies because if the company increases the price, because in some cases they have the incentive to increase the price because they want to recover from bad management and they want to get more interest from the developing country. In that cases, the company will increase the price drastically. What happened in their paradigm? People have no choice in their paradigm because of the existence of the foreign company, domestic companies will be almost eradicated. That's why even if the price is so high, the people have no choice but to buy foreign companies. This is more harmful for the consumers in the developing country. On the other hand, what happened in our paradigm? In our paradigm, the people still have the choice to choose the products, whether they want to buy foreign products or local products. So if the foreign company increase the price of arbitrary, then they can choose to buy local shop. And then what happens is that first, the local people don't have to be harmed by the foreign product. And second, foreign company will know that they cannot arbitrarily increase the price because if they do, then the people will lose incentive to buy foreign products. That's why foreign company have to take into account of the foreign people for these reasons. This, as for the consumers, in our side is superior to their side. For this reason, we are happy to propose this one.
Thank you, Deputy Prime Minister. Next one, Karapan, the Deputy Leader position to deliver a speech in summary. Siahia.
Mr. Speaker, two strange assumptions the premise of that segment has. One, foreign large retailers are selling only foreign products. No, they are also selling local products too, in a much more efficient way rather than local retailers, because each local retailer doesn't have capability to collect so many kinds of products produced in other types of local areas. But large foreign retailers have capability to collect so many different types of local products produced in a different types of local areas in the country. Second of all, foreign products are always bad. No, we believe the poor people in developing countries should also access the Disney DVD or Hello Kitty of Sanrio. They're going to be more happier rather than keeping the status quo under their proposal. Three clash points in my speech. First of all, what's the incentive of these multinational retailers? Second of all, how should we deal with interests of domestic industry and the workers that they're worried about in the debate? Third of all, what are the differences between foreign multinational retailers and domestic local retailers? On the first level, the incentive of multinational corporations and retailers. The point of information that Takto gave to my partner is that those like foreign local multinational corporations don't have an incentive to go to developing countries when the price gouging is not allowed. There are three responses. First of all, they have incentive because they want cheap labor force in the first place. Compared to the labor force in an advanced country, the labor force in the developing countries are much, much cheaper. Second of all, they have incentive to cultivate potential markets because they want to maximize the number of customers all across the world. That's why Nike is expanding their business, even in the developing countries. Third of all, the multinational corporations want to have new clients, not limited to consumers. That's why even in India, with a huge restriction imposed by Tata Group, still so many multinational corporations are expanding enterprise in those markets, Mrs. Speaker, ladies and gentlemen. Second of all, the Deputy Prime Minister explained is, that those four multinational corporations are able to produce products with a very few number of people, thereby they don't really hire people. No, that's not true. They need those who sell those products by speaking local languages. Please imagine the situation. In Toys R Us in Ikebukuro, for example, workers, they are not American, they are Japanese people because they need to speak Japanese to sell the products to Japanese customers. It's a very strange idea that all multinational corporations only hire their own people. That's very strange. Third of all, Mrs. Speaker, ladies and gentlemen, they have incentive to educate non-skilled workers because they need productive workers in the near future in order to expand their enterprise. That's why Nike or Toyota or Nissan have been cultivating the skilled workers after hiring them in their factories, in their subsidiaries, and a branch in the local areas in so many different types of Asian countries, Mrs. Speaker. Therefore, their claim is not really, realistic. More than that, they are worried about the cultural imperialism or invasion because the local product will disappear. First of all, the multinational retailers have incentive to localize their own products in order to answer the demands of local people. Just that's exactly why McDonald's in Korea provides bulgogi burgers, or like Toys R Us in Japan provides toys of Kamen Rider Kuga for Japanese boys. They're always retailers have incentive to localize their products or collect local products in order to meet the demands of local people. Moving on to the second flashpoint of the debate, before that, I will take you thousands of information. All right, go.
Okay, wait, be comparative. Which side can hire more people? Walmart, who have technology already, or domestic companies, which unfortunately does not have a mechanic, so have to hire a lot more people?
Like, domestic companies have already hired sufficient number of people. There's no more, potentiality for that. Like, when the large-scale multinational retailers come into this country, they need to establish factories, they need to establish infrastructure, they need to organize the other types of social capital in order to establish business. That's why Toys R Us successfully created lots of employment in developing countries. In the past, that's what Costco or Walmart have been doing in African countries, but other types of developing countries in the world. You can't really say domestic corporations have capacity or capability to hire 1,000 types of people. That's so unrealistic. Moving on to the second flashpoint in the debate, how should we deal with domestic industry? Mrs. Speaker, why should the state prioritize vested interests of domestic industries and their workers in the first place at the expense of lots and lots of poor people who cannot even access daily basic commodity? Just like case of agriculture, domestically produced vegetables are very expensive. That's why peanuts produced in Chiba are fucking expensive in the status quo. Because these farmers engage in lobbying activity to the administration, for example. These domestic producers, domestic farmers already gain a massive hierarchical vested interest in the areas, in the local areas. We believe this kind of corruptive, malfeasant relation between local farmers, local producers, and administration is particularly harmful for the vast majority of poor customers. State has a responsibility to prioritize the interests of the most vulnerable and disenfranchised population over the interests of already privileged groups of people in society. Second of all, even jobless people on the upper arm are able to gain job in a relevant market. Those who used to work in a supermarket are able to work in Costco or Walmart by utilizing their ability. They can be hired on the upper arm too. Third of all, elimination of bad quality products are good for consumers.
If the local products are good enough, then consumers will continue to buy those products even under their paradigm, Mr. Speaker. That's why, you know, Japanese rice or Japanese cherry blossom are still popular among consumers, even though, you know, there are cheap, you know, cherry blossom from other countries, Mr. Speaker, ladies and gentlemen. Finally, what are the differences between foreign retailers and local retailers? One, the what products they deal with are totally different. There are certain products that they cannot locally produce because of weather or geographical condition. More than the cultural product with more liberal, progressive ideas should are only dealt by these local, multinational corporations. Like a DVD of Sex and the City, or Gossip Girl, or How I Met Your Mother, those kind of liberal products should come into this market. That's not going to be sold by the local retailers because of the idea of misogyny, or like a patriarchy, and other types of cultural stereotypes. But second of all, price control capacity is totally different. Hirohita pointed out, imported products are good enough. No, they're expensive due to tariff. But, Mr. Speaker, the multinational foreign retailers can produce, have their own factories and facility. They can produce, they can procure necessary ingredients or materials themselves and locally produce them with their own supply chain. That's what L'Oreal, or Toys R Us, or Häagen-Dazs are doing in the state school. We can expect more, you know, much cheaper price for lower, better quality. That's why we oppose. Thank you.
Thank you, Deputy Opposition. Next, I'm going to call upon the member of the government to open a case between several minutes. Ah.
I'm a bit nervous since it's the first time I'm going to be on a judge list, so if I don't crappy speeches, forgive me. So there are two things I want to confirm in my introduction. Firstly, I thought it was extremely offensive for the people who live in Chiba Prefecture, like my partners. I think you should have to apologize for that. Second,
I do.
Okay, given that opening opposition didn't pretty much mention about the harm the opening government have told us, how those like local shops are going to shut down because those multinational companies won't be able to be cracked down right, from the power of the local companies, which means they have pretty much conceded the local shop does not exist anymore, right? We think that was the opening government material which they have actually failed to mention to, right? Given that, what I'm going to do as an extension is to give you, based on comparison, three things. Firstly, what is actually going to happen in after plan, looking at the situation where when we actually prohibit these foreign large retailers, multinational companies coming in, how domestic companies are actually going to grow, and why that is a beneficial thing to do. And second, I'm going to compare the idea of two things. Firstly, about the idea of the money, since opening up then told us, look, we can utilize the money by buying a cheap product and, for example, utilize the education and so forth, right? I'm going to compare which side can actually utilize a budget that each family have more effectively. And second, also I'm going to compare about the job, right? That was also one of the clash with being brought by the opening hub, which can actually give more jobs possibility and job market to the people we think it's our fight. So before that, two points of response. So firstly, they told us, right, vegetables are expensive because we have tariff. Okay, we, if possible, are going to like cut off the tariff so people can actually buy the cheap vegetables, right? Okay, that's it. Second, they told us multinational corporation brings a benefit to those workers because workers can actually learn how to manage those things, right? That is right, for example, branch company, then after that they go outside and create own business so forth, right? We think even if there are some modern examples, we think in general cases this is unrealistic, right? Because multinational corporation incentive is actually dominate the market for a very long time and not to provide an incentive, not to provide an ability for certain workers to create a shop in the places to actually, for example, sell things and take away the pie the multinational corporation corporation we're having, right? We think in general the reason for the multinational corporation does not give any, for example, technology or techniques or any kind of abilities, it's because they want to dominate a market. We think even if there are some modern examples, we think that is something very unrealistic. We don't think that happens in many cases. Thirdly, they told us local people are actually raising up the prices because there's a corruption between the administration and local people with Chibas, right? So we think that harm is going to be exacerbated on their side, because we have to realize now what the multinational corporation is doing, that they would know that, look, local farmers are making this corruption, then why not us, right? Yes. The multinational corporation are going to create a corruption situation, system within the administration, and also we think these multinational corporations would be better at making this corruption because they're the ones who have far more amounts of the money they can actually pay to the administrative people compared to the local farmers, right? Which means all the harm they have talked about, monopolies, price cutting, is going to be exacerbated on their side because administration does not care what the multinational corporation guys are doing about things, right? We think that harm is obviously detrimental for their side. So let's go to our argument. I think I can go to. So firstly, what's going to happen after plan? But before that, yes, sure.
The collaboration between administration and a multinational corporation much better than that with local people, because those multinational corporations can provide diverse types of cheaper products for those people rather than local farmers.
No. What's going to happen is, if there can be a corruption between administration and multinational companies, even if the multinational companies make a price gouging and actually make the cheap product into an expensive product, administration would not say, no, you cannot do that, because they are happy with the corruption and money they get from the multinational companies. So we don't see the benefit you have talked about does not stand. I see the monopoly still exists in these situations. So firstly, what's going to happen in after plan? So opening government have already successfully talked about the point, what's going to happen in the status quo, right? Well, what we're going to tell you is, when we actually, what kind of the benefit we can give in the long term? We believe that own domestic companies are actually going to obviously grow, right? Because we have to realize, consumers, not unfortunately, but have to buy a product that comes from the domestic companies, and then they're actually going, those domestic companies are actually going to receive amounts of the money they have actually received from all their profit, right? What they're going to do is actually keep selling a product, but also invest that amount of the money they have received to the other, for example, new technologies, education, buying a new technology from the developed countries, and so forth, and make the product quality better, and also make the product more cheaper, right? And we think there is no situation where, for example, one strong company dominate. We think there will be like a branch, like a small company that's going to compete together in the same levels, right? And they can have a competition that also raises, for example, an improvement in quality and improvement also cheaper prices, because that is when the healthy competition, which opposition wants to support, is going to function on our side, right? Then the consequence is we can have, and maybe in the long term, maybe in the middle ground terms, those people in the places can actually buy things that is something effective or that is something safe, that have a high sanity, and we think those people are actually going to gain a benefit. And we think this is also going to create a far more job opportunities, but that's going to be a sort of comparison, so just wait for a bit, a minute. So then, we think that it's going to happen after plan, right? Then given that both sides exist, where a couple number of companies are actually going to compete and grow, which is domestic countries, and one big industry are going to dominate for a very long time, which is better based on comparison. So firstly about the monies, right? Opening opposition told us, when you actually buy cheap products, then you can actually save the monies, right? So, but we have to realize, then money is actually going to be used in both sides anyway, right? We're talking about the basic commodities where people actually have to pay monies, right? And we agree that then money, those people may have to pay a high amount of the money compared to the domestic, right, of MNC at the beginning. But we have to realize the money that these local people actually pay to the shop, that actually goes to someone's family's incomes, right? And then those people who actually earn money can actually utilize the money in, for example, their education and so forth, right? Then given that both sides use the money, which is better, we think it's our side is better, because in their power act, when multinational corporations receive a certain benefit, they would take the benefit out from the developing country and make it to like an own like an industry corporation which exists in the United States, right? Which means certain proportional amounts of the money is actually going away from the developing countries, which is never going to contribute to the economy of the developing countries. We think on our side, at least, people, the money is actually going to circulate within the developing countries, and we think that is going to be create a more beneficial situation for investment into the economies, education, job training, whatever so forth, comparative than the opposition side. Second comparison idea about the jobs, right? So they told us they have an incentive to actually hire these things, right? Well, firstly, we agree, but that same logic applies to the domestic companies, right? The domestic company also hire domestic peoples, right? The comparison is, obviously, multinational corporation does not have an incentive to hire lots of people, because Misty wanted to talk about, look, those people are cheap, right? No. to actually make a product cheap, they have already received the benefit by creating all this product in, for example, sweatshops, right? We're not talking about the company, we're not talking about the factories, we're talking about the retailers, factory selling, right? Then we have to realize, when there's a lot of machine and also technology to actually minimize the number of laborers in multinational corporations, they does not have any wish to hire. On our side, we have to talk about the primitive company, which have to actually rely on to the manpower, right? Have to hire a lot more people, compared to the opposition side, gives a lot more benefit for the people by giving money and hire a lot more people. This is definitely beneficial. So based on comparison, based on the money and also the job training and the jobs, we think our side is better, that's why it is.
Thank you, member of the GAB. Next one, call upon the member of the OP to open your case within 7 minutes. Yeah.
Mr. Speaker, we agree with the idea someone have to be the jobless. Yes, we agree. But however, Mr. Speaker, we think in our paradigm that much more people can be employed. So that's why we say that our side of the house is comparatively better than their side of the house. That's why we are very proud to propose. I'm going to argue 0 points as a member of the opposition. Firstly, I'm going to argue how the external benefit will come up in our paradigm. Secondly, how we should distribute the unemployment or employment to the people on the ground. But before that, a few points of rebuttals to the other side of the house. So firstly, they told us like usage of the money, in terms of the usage of money, because like money, like in their paradigm, the money are more likely to be circulated within the domestic like market. That's why this policy is necessary. But we say, Mr. Speaker, that that's not true, right? Because in our paradigm, to a certain extent, the economy itself are more likely to grow. So that's why pie itself became grow. So that's why even if some money will get out of the domestic arena, domestic economy, so we say that still the people can be benefit from that. But that's why I don't think that is necessarily the case. But secondly, right, they told us, look, like because in our paradigm, the domestic the foreign company are less likely to hire large amount of the people. That's why like the advancement does not necessarily contribute to the economy themselves. But we say no, right? We say because at the end of the day, the large foreign company also have the incentive to hire the large number of the people on the ground. Precisely because, Mr. Speaker, at the end of the day, even in our paradigm, people are more likely to spend the money again and again and again. But that's why we said even in our paradigm, opportunity of employment will be distributed to the people on the ground. That's why we said even in our paradigm, people can be hired. That's why I don't think that is necessarily the case. But moving on to our extension. Firstly, how the external benefit will occur in our paradigm, right? So we have to recognize, Mr. Speaker, the reason why the domestic price of the retail goods, stuff, are very, very high price. The reason why, Mr. Speaker, the price is very, very high is precisely because, Mr. Speaker, firstly, as they told us, they don't have the technology, but also secondly, that they developing country does not necessarily have the better infrastructure compared to the first world the country. At the end of the day, Mr. Speaker, if the developing country do not have the good infrastructure, what will happen is that the oftentimes in order to transport for example the stuff to the market, it takes long time. That's why, Mr. Speaker, at the end of the day, that because of the lack of the infrastructure, they have to spend more time and more human capital, or more they're more likely to waste the kinds of time and the money and the food. That's why, Mr. Speaker, at the end of the day, the price increase. In our paradigm, what will happen is that because of the lack of the infrastructure is like very, very important issue for the large retail company, foreign retail company. So what will happen is that the large foreign large retailers are more likely to construct the infrastructure within the market itself. So for example, Mr. Speaker, what was happened in the African country was that actually the private company constructed the road in order to transport their stuff to the market. So that's why we say that in our paradigm, the infrastructure will occur, infrastructure will be constructed. We say that is particularly important because at the end of the day, that kind of infrastructure can be beneficial not only for the large retailer, but also the other like economic entity. Let's say like, I don't know, like for example, just a transportation company or just a taxi company or things like that, right? So that's why we say that because of the external benefit, which will not be coming from the local retailer, because the local retailer doesn't have the money enough to construct like infrastructure. We say our paradigm is much better because we have the external the benefit to begin with. So moving on to the next issue, the how we should distribute the employment to the people on the ground. We say, Mr. Speaker, yes, in our paradigm, what will happen is that the people on the ground does not necessarily have to spend the large proportion of the money on the food. Because, Mr. Speaker, in the developing country, in the status quo, the people in the developing country have to spend the tons of the money on the food, right? Because of that, as I said before, the food is very, very expensive. At the end of the day, because the reduction of the price of the food, what will happen is that the people can spend the more money on the other industry. At the end of the day, what will happen is that the more that employment will be distributed to the people on the ground. Why is it so important? It's precisely because, Mr. Speaker, as I said before, in the status quo, like the employment are highly like concentrated on the retail market or like local retail related market or local retailer related business, right? In our paradigm, what will happen is that because of the reduction of the price of the food, the more like economic opportunity will come up into the other like industry, the other industry will hire the people. Why is it so important is that the reason why it is important is precisely because, Mr. Speaker, compared to the types of the people who are hired right now, the people, the benefit or economic opportunity are more likely to be fairer or like broader, right? So that's why we say, Mr. Speaker, because in our paradigm, there is more necessity to hire the various kinds of the people, the more like opportunity will be like available for every single citizen. That's why we say this is important. Yes.
So when other local retailing shops cracked down and decided they cannot get inside the businesses, who are talking about that, like new people coming into the market?
Mr. Speaker, at the end of the day, even if in our paradigm, like some local retailers are closed down, shut down, but we say still there are the citizens who have the money. Because at the end of the day, even in our paradigm, the people can be benefit from the advancement of the large retailer. For example, the people who are selling the food to the large retailer, if there are people who are dealing with the import of that particular food or particular like commodity or particular like DVD or whatever, right? So that's why even in our paradigm, there are the people who can benefit from the large retailer. That's why they can hire the other people, that they can hire, start the new business. That's why we say even in our paradigm, the kind of the economic opportunity will be distributed to begin with. So at the end of the day, Mr. Speaker, we told you firstly that in our paradigm, there are the external benefits, such as the construction of the infrastructure, which is actually available for every single citizen. But secondly, we told you, Mr. Speaker, in our paradigm, because like reduction of the price of the food, the people are more likely to use the money. At the end of the day, because of the use of the money on the various kinds of the sector or the like business, we say the business or like the opportunity will be distributed to every single citizen, the various kinds of citizen. That's why we are able to do this.
Oh, sorry. Thank you, Nemo. Oh. Next one, the corresponds to the whip to deliver your whip speech business time. Yeah, yeah.
Sorry.
Thank you.
Mr. Speaker, open governments argue for short-term problem solution mechanism for local retailers, and opening option argues for customers' access to products of larger amounts and larger and cheaper price, and closing option argues for something that is on the same line with the opening option, not so much extensive. And we emphasize a closing government that the issue about money circulation in the domestic area, and what if, and also we emphasize what if they don't. These companies, the foreign companies, don't come into these countries, and how those domestic industry will grow up. And we can answer to the important question about job and money, which side can create more important and more improvement in domestic scale, not sort of sucked up by the foreign companies, right? And foreign countries. So there are just one clash point in this debate, because basically economic debate doesn't have so much clash points. It's about foreign retailers. Middle and long-term influence on local economy, and how whether it is beneficial or not. And we think by excluding these retailing companies, we think that these domestic markets will grow up, and domestic people's life will be better improved. So before that, one point of reputation to the closing option, opposition extension, just example of benefits that is on the same scale as opening option and not so much extensive. They said there will be external benefits. The lack of infrastructure will be tackled in this case. We think this doesn't answer anything about extension about local circulation of money, which we have emphasized in our case, which improves the stock of local people and improve tax budget, and it enables the government to spend more on constructing those roads, or those kind of things that the closing option emphasized. They said that MNCs will definitely make improvements in terms of infrastructure. We think we are not sure about that, right? We think in the first place, those MNCs might have interest to improve infrastructure for their own business, but doesn't have any incentive to improve anything about other companies' business, right? We think in this situation, if there are infrastructure that these MNCs created, other companies cannot benefit anything from it, right? Because all of those infrastructure is used by this MNC, right? So we think there's no such external benefits for other companies and for other people. So, main clash, foreign retailers, middle and long-term influence, whether it is good or bad. So, open government focused upon unemployment of locals, imbalance in efficiency of production or marketing or sales, will affect local small middle-sized retailers in worse way than foreign large retailers. And local labor forces will be faced with severe unemployment, so on and so forth. It seems, Mr. Speaker, in opening heart, foreign countries will lower the price of their products. It is consensus in this space. And also, however, Mr. Speaker, the opening government and opening option disagreed about whether the result is unemployment, right? So the opening option said, firstly, foreign retailers will make the factories and stores, etc., and it will enlarge their employment. We think that most of the things given by the opening option that accommodate workers are not really relevant to retailer in the first place, right? Factory, it is not about retailer, right? Or also farms, it is not relevant to retailers, right? We think farms are farmers, right? And also factories is the thing of toys or Legos, for example. So, Mr. Speaker, Toys R Us doesn't create Lego products, right? Lego creates Lego products, right? So we think Toys R Us is just selling those things, right? We think in this situation, it doesn't seem that foreign retailers will improve the employment in such a scale, right? Secondly, they said, by taking this proposal, we can prevent local retailers' rent-seeking activity, right? So locals have connection with local administration to regulate supply, to increase price of their products through lobbying, so on and so forth. I have basically no way to refute this point, right? So this is basically the basic theory written in Yu Hikaku's textbook of political science. But comparatively speaking, Mr. Speaker, it is unfair to attribute corruption only to domestic industries, right? We think it might also be true that those other foreign industries will have the same method of this corruption whatsoever, right? So we think there's not a problem of problem of domestic retailers. So there are two things compared with this: how foreign retailers is harmful, and how the absence of foreign retailers might be beneficial to the domestics. So firstly, domestic industries will grow up more. Basically, the competition in industry occurs only when there is no superpower in the market that can offer so cheap price of products that they can sell their products by like half price compared with other local companies, right? If they, like, as a result, less customer purchased in local stores cannot pay for its debt, and they can, they cannot continue borrowing money from banks, and they will lose any credibility, and they cannot even compete in the market. That is a harm of coming to these local retailers if there is like foreign retailers existing, right? So we think in terms of this, there will be just harm. So before moving on, yes, yeah.
Okay, premise of your extension is that many different types of corporations are competing in the same industry or in the same markets. But in reality, there are not many companies competing in the same market because the market itself is small enough in the first place. Therefore, monopoly occurs under your paradigm too. Competition that you describe is not realistic in this
so
age.
We think in terms of retailers, we think there doesn't have to be any diversity of selling, right? We think there are retailers, that is enough. They are buying products and selling the products a bit higher price. We think that is enough. We think there doesn't have to be farmers, or there doesn't have to be factory of toys. We think there will be just retailers. That is enough. We think diversity of market is not the focus of this debate. So, and also we told you that as this competition, we think as this competition among like small size, those local retailers, and we think this competition enables local industries improvement in quality of their service. They can enlarge scale of business, and they can become more capable of accommodating more workers. Naturally, development in this way is unlimited compared with MNCs if subordinate workers just flows and not stably employed, right? We think our case is much more superior. So, and also, secondly, circulation of money will be concluded in domestic economic activity. We think MNCs don't have incentive to circulate money only in developing countries, my partner has extended, not what responded to, right? Profit goes more to the money who are not really the domestics, right? Which and we think profit goes more to managers than to the workers, which will be exactly taken to which money will be taken to the foreign developed countries from which these companies come from, right? So we think in this situation, we think the profit that is made as a result of this economic activity is not benefit. It's not a benefit for the locals and domestics. And we think in this situation, we think we have to exclude them. Thank you.
Thank you for a good lecture by Yuhi Kak. Next, Tamara Korpon, the position with two will deliver your mixed meeting service. Yeah, yeah.
Mr. Speaker, what my partner brought you are the important observation on the debate from the closing is immensely important. Because, Mr. Speaker, my partner clearly characterized the state of developing countries, and through this process, Mr. Speaker, in the status quo, because of the existence of large foreign retailers, Mr. Speaker, large foreign retailers can benefit to all kinds of industry as a whole, precisely because, Mr. Speaker, in exchange for cheap prices, in exchange for higher quality of food, Mr. Speaker, there are millions of room for the consumers in developing states to use their own money beyond the basic needs, ladies and gentlemen. That is why, Mr. Speaker, my partner extension is fantastic. That's why I'm immensely proud of my partner. I'm going to talk about two things in my speech. First and foremost, I'm going to talk about the necessity of foreign large retailers, and second, I'm going to talk about the efficacy of foreign large retailers. But, Mr. Speaker, let's be realistic. Under that side of the house, it takes a lot of time for local retailers to grow themselves. As a result of that, Mr. Speaker, the key here is that under that side of the house, local people have no choice but to depend on higher prices food and less quality of food. As a result of that, Mr. Speaker, the consensus on this debate should be the fact
that the local people have no choice but to depend on those industries. Through this process, we think this is tantamount to deprivation of demand of other types of industry, like, for example, entertainment beyond basic needs. Yeah. That's the problem we have to rectify, and that's the beauty of the status quo. Based on the I'm going to talk about on the first issue about necessity, the key logic we got from that side of the house is, unemployment is seriously problematic due to the large foreign retailers. On the first of all, Mr. Speaker, this is highly unlikely. Why that? Two reasons for that. Number one, due to point of information from the closing opposition. There is comparative superiority to the local people, like the example of knowing the local language, local transportation system, and so forth. This is the point of information from closing opposition in the first side, to which we had insufficient attention from that side of the house. Number two, Mr. Speaker, more importantly, there is massive incentive for the foreign companies, foreign retailers, to minimize anti-piracy from the local people in the first place. Let's say boycott movement, ladies and gentlemen. When it comes to immensely serious problem, when it comes to high employment, there is going to be boycott movement from the local people to the foreign retailers, ladies and gentlemen. Therefore, Mr. Speaker, in order to prevent those kinds of boycott movement, ladies and gentlemen, foreign retailers have massive incentive to minimize anti-piracy from the local people. Therefore, Mr. Speaker, irrespective of machine industry and irrespective of mechanical industry of those kinds of retailers, Mr. Speaker, foreign retailers have massive incentive to kill employment of the local society in the first place, to which we have insufficient attention from that side of the house. Therefore, Mr. Speaker, profit is more likely to go down to the local people, not the managers of the society, precisely because it is absolutely necessary for the profit maximization of the foreign retailers. And this is a new point, new engagement to that side of the house. On the second level, Mr. Speaker, what so wrong is that? Because, Mr. Speaker, there are millions of external positive effects which is accessible to all kinds of people in the local industry. And this is the important observation which my partner brought you extension on this way. For example, let's concretize material from my partner. For example, consumers have more room to use their own money for entertainment beyond the basic needs. And through this process, we are more likely to enhance the demands of diverse spectrum of industry from the consumer, because consumers have more room to use their own money beyond basic needs. And thereby, those diverse spectrum of industry, like example, entertainment, have more room to hire more local people. Mr. Speaker, this is a new material we have brought you. Moreover, Mr. Speaker, if restaurants can buy raw materials at cheaper prices, local restaurants are more likely to hire more people, precisely because, Mr. Speaker, local restaurants have more rooms to hire more people in the first place. And this is the positive externality we have brought you an extension on this debate. In response to that, Mr. Speaker, we got from government, the those local infrastructure are only for the corporation. We think, Mr. Speaker, in the first place, this is not the case, because local infrastructure or foreign retailers necessary is accessible to everyone. Let's say street for transportation, ladies and gentlemen. Why is that important, ladies and gentlemen? Because the benefit of those transportation can be trickled down to every kind of industry, ladies and gentlemen. Because, Mr. Speaker, movement of the people and the movement of commodity is essential for the prosperity of every kind of the industry, every kind of industry in the first place. Therefore, due to the existence of foreign local industry, we are more likely to enhance the local infrastructure and so forth, local transportation system. And therefore, through this process, we are more likely to enrich the economy as a whole. And secondly, even that the case, to a certain extent, Mr. Speaker, for public reconstruction, for enriching transportation system, Mr. Speaker, local foreign retailers necessitate the constructor in the local industrial sphere. Therefore, Mr. Speaker, we are more likely to hire more people. Recognizing that, which can inclusively give benefit to the local economy, Mr. Speaker, that side of the house is willing to protect only local food industry growth under the government bench. But under our paradigm of opposition bench, even their case does, Mr. Speaker, we are more likely to expand the demand of all kinds of people, and we are more likely to have more rooms to expand diverse spectrum industry. Therefore, Mr. Speaker, we are more likely to give a benefit to all kinds of people, inclusively, ladies and gentlemen. Therefore, Mr. Speaker, only possible via Australia. Go.
Okay, thanks a lot for new materials. But let's say, why local people can do a buying boycott when we're talking about the daily commodity which is essential to sustain their life for every day? We don't think those people will be able to actually do this buying boycott for a long time. That is unpopular.
Because, Mr. Speaker, if, as they characterize, unemployment is immensely problematic
for the daily life of those kinds of people, local people have massive incentive to make boycott movement in the first place. Therefore, your point mentioned doesn't work. So on the last issue about efficacy, Mr. Speaker, the idea coming from that side has, especially from closing, money can cycle within the domestic arena, that's fantastic, and moreover, local retailers can compete each other. But the key here is that that side has never ever show us how those kinds of industries can compete each other so effectively, so efficiently in the first place. Recognizing that it takes millions or millions of time for local retailers to get techniques from those kinds of foreign retailers in the first place. Through this process, what is the consequence? Is that that side of the house is forced, or vast majority of poor people, that vast majority of people is in those kinds developing states to depend on higher priced food, and because those kinds of food are essential, Mr. Speaker, this is tantamount to deprivation of demand of all kinds of diverse spectrum of industry, and this is an important observation we have brought to you on this page. Therefore, Mr. Speaker, foreign large retailers can benefit to all kinds of people with for the superiority of the society. That's why we are immensely proud. So forth.